If you're transitioning from conventional abrasives to CBN, or if you're seeing issues like burn or finish patterns, you might not be dressing a wheel correctly. In this episode of the Grinding Chronicles, we're going to talk about how to traverse dress a vitrified CBN wheel with a rotary diamond dresser.
Welcome to the Grinding Chronicles, presented by CDT Rotary Dressers Product Manager, who we call the Rotary Regulator, also known as Troy Giacherio.
Hi, I'm Troy Giacherio, Product Manager for CDT's Rotary Dresser Department. Vitrified CBN wheels require very specific parameters. In this video, we're going to look at parameters like velocity ratio, overlap ratio, depth of dress, and dress interval. But first, let's talk about what's actually happening when you're dressing and truing a wheel. Truing and dressing are often used interchangeably, but the two are distinct processes. Truing is adjusting the wheel shape or profile, while dressing is sharpening the wheel. Dressing also removes any debris the wheel has collected during the grinding process. Now that you better understand what's happening when you dress a vitrified CBN wheel, let's look at the specific machine settings you should run to optimize your grinding process. The first of these parameters is velocity ratio. This is calculated by dividing the velocity of the diamond roll by the velocity of the grinding wheel, and the recommended ratio is 0.8. This ratio allows the diamond roll to effectively remove the bonded material and expose the abrasive. With a traverse rotary diamond dresser, overlap ratio refers to how quickly it traverses the face of the wheel to generate the profile and sharpen the wheel. For every revolution of the grinding wheel, the diamond roll needs to move a specific amount so you don't get an overlap where the dresser is dwelling in the same spot for too long. For a vitrified CBN wheel, the recommended overlap ratio is 2-4. Meaning that the diamond roll should only be in one location between 2 and 4 revolutions of the wheel. Another important parameter is the depth of dress. This refers to how deeply the diamond roll is feeding into the grinding wheel and how much material is being removed per pass. The recommended depth of dress for a vitrified CBN wheel is 2/10 per pass. Ideally, you only want one pass to save time. This is especially important to reduce downtime if you're producing a high volume of parts. Finally, let's talk about dress interval. This is how frequently you should dress your grinding wheel, which often depends on your application. Conventional abrasives, you typically have to dress after grinding a few parts. With vitrified CBN wheels, we've seen the number go to hundreds of parts. There's no magic number for your dress interval. You just need to make sure that it's appropriate for your process. If you push the wheel too long between dressing, you could see variations in your part, and you'll need to remove more material with each dress. If you dress too frequently, you're unnecessarily removing material and reducing the life of your grinding wheel. So how do you know if you're dressing properly? There are two simple ways to measure the effects of dressing: power draw and surface finish. Most CNC machines today have a power meter on the spindle that tells you how much power is being used to grind each part. Effectively dressing your grinding wheel will reduce the power draw. But if you see the power meter begin to creep up, you know it's time to dress. If the wheel isn't cutting free, it could cause burn, thermal fractures, and changes to the surface finish. If you're dressing properly, your rotary diamond dresser and your vitrified CBN wheel will last a very long time. You'll also produce high quality parts at a great pace with little or no variation. However, if you're operating within the recommendations and you're still getting finish patterns or burn on your parts, you might need help pinpointing the problem. At CDT, we have a team of experts who will come into your facility, learn your process and application, and troubleshoot the issue. We can look at things like coolant delivery, machine functioning, part fixturing, and settings with our portable grinding lab to determine the best course of action. If you have concerns about dressing parameters, or if you need help optimizing your grinding process, we'd love to help. To reach out, send us an email at thegrindingchronicles@cdtusa.net.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like, follow, and subscribe button, and get ready to learn something new in another episode from Continental Diamond Tool.